Hey guys, how's everyone doing? I'm Ganesh.
Hi, I'm Sumaiya.
Welcome back to our channel, guys. Guys, thank you so much for watching part 1. This is the part 2 of our journey and here it goes.
We finished our day at work that day, and when we went back home, mom, dad were very excited and they came home and they were waiting for us to come. They got food, sweets, fruit, so many things. They were really very happy because Ayan was the first grandchild in our family. Amma used to call me every day to check on my health and ask if I want something. Please eat, don't keep your cravings to you, have whatever you want to eat, she used to say. The same way, Mama, Mommy, they used to call me every day. If not every day, every alternate day, Mommy used to call me and she used to tell me, be careful. First 3 months are very important for you because I had a few complications. So she used to say you have to be really very careful. She gave me a lot of advices as well. Due to all myths, we did not share it to everyone. It was just a
near and dear ones. So that's it.
So I luckily I did not have any morning sickness or nausea or mood swings. The only thing I had was craving.
So she had like a lot of cravings, guys. That too, she has a sweet tooth and she had cravings for ice cream, what sweets, chocolates and all those stuff. And she used to ask me in some odd time, guys. So that was even more painful. So I was not used to all these things. So I used to get some stuff during like midnight also. I used to like take my bike and get some stuff for her. And that was good. Those times were difficult but nice.
But I have to tell you something which was really very sweet of Ganesh. Women who are pregnant, they must be relating this. Doctor says we should eat soaked almonds and we should drink milk in the morning. So every night, whatever time he used to come back from office, let it be 1, 2, 3, he used to make sure he soak almonds for me. And next day morning, he used to wake up early and then peel those almonds and keep ready for me and make the pregnancy powder milk for me. That was really very sweet of him. And even in the night, if I was feeling very uneasy or very discomfort, he used to wake up, rub my back and bear all the difficulties which I was going through. He was also going through the same because he was very much worried. And Ganesh is such a person who loves kids immensely. He always loved kids. So he was super excited and he wanted to take care of me. And when we were just two of us, he really took care of me like a baby during my entire pregnancy journey. He used to prepare breakfast, and due to the hormonal changes and all, I used to be awake till late night, and then I used to wake up very late in the morning. So he used to prepare breakfast and then lunch, and then he used to wake me up saying, "Sumi, office ka time ho raha, let's go." So that's really very sweet of you.
Thank you, no problem. So guys, what had happened was like when we were going to office one fine day, she was not feeling well and she went immediately, she was taken to hospital and we were checking that there was some bleeding. It was the second month, I believe, just start of second month. I believe. And the doctor said that you need to take a bed rest for a month. That is when I was like very concerned.
Yeah.
I think we had called Meenu to stay with us, right? Yeah. So, because there was no one to take care of her, knowing the fact like mom and dad, they used to stay
far away
from us. So we thought, why not invite one of her really close friend, her friend Meenu. She's in Germany right now, and she said she can come over and stay. So she was there for like 4 to 5 months, I believe.
Yeah.
So she was of a really good help to her, And she used to work from home at times, and she used to come with me to office. We used to go together, and there was like a, we were like a family, right? We were like a family, and she was taking care, I was taking care of her. So my role was that whatever diet chart was given by the doctor, I had to like strictly follow. And luckily, those 1 month of her bed rest went smoothly, and she recovered well.
My mom also used to come during that 1 month after my dad went to office.
So she used to come every day and stay until night.
Ganesh.
By the time I used to come from office, and I used to take care of her. So that was the routine then. Like immediately in a month, she recovered well. The first 3 months of the pregnancy are very, very, very important because
The fetus is weak. If you're strong enough, nothing would happen. But then if you have any health issues, you are advised to take some rest. That's what I was given because I had some bleeding. My fetus was a little weak, so I was advised strict bed rest. And one more thing, guys, during my pregnancy journey, whenever Samira's shooting location was near our home, she used to come over and spend time with me and the baby. That's how Ayan and Samira got connected even when he was in my womb. And he used to respond to Samira a lot, and he used to respond to Ganesh a lot. And definitely not me, and he still doesn't respond to me. He just listens to Ganesh and Samira, and he's most pampered by them. Happily, we completed 7 months, and then we decided to have a baby shower. In Telugu, it's called Simantam.
In Tamil, it's called Valagapu. Since we had a registered marriage only, so my parents and her parents, they both decided to celebrate this baby shower grandly.
My mom asked Amma ki what all you guys do, and I think I don't know if it is a Tamil culture or not, but in Ganesh family, the first time the woman comes and sit, and I think when the bangles are given, we have to wear a black color sari, then the woman again goes and change to a different
red color.
Black, because there shouldn't be any evil eye.
Yeah.
Because of that.
They planned really nicely, and my mom and her mom, they coordinated really well and planned accordingly. And my mother, she found a perfect day for this Valagapu and to happen. So Amma and mom, they both coordinated really well, and they planned everything in advance, what needs to be done. They had this checklist and all, and my mother, she shared with her mom, and
once my mom
she came from Delhi. She came during Diwali, and from then onwards my mother and her mother, they both decided to go for a shopping together, and they bought loads of stuff, the stuff required, including sari and all those stuff.
Clothes for everyone who are coming,
and it was nice. So, so immediately after that was done, the date was set, and all our near and dear ones, they came, they flew from Delhi, Bangalore, and
even Harita Mami came from US for this function. I mean, she had other family commitment, but she made sure she pays her visit.
Yeah.
That was really very sweet of her. And she got a lot of goodies also for Ayan. And it was all nice and happy event. Definitely, Amma cried a lot because it was happy tears. And she did sing for me. And she's a very good singer, guys. And mom also had happy tears. It was just happy tears. Both the mothers were very emotional. And my friends came. We had cake cutting. We had fun. Samira planned for a few games. It was all happy event. I never thought it would be so nice. And I'm happy ki everything went on good without any misunderstandings or without anyone getting hurt. And after that, after the baby shower, Amma Appa went back, everyone went back to Delhi and their respective places. The baby shower bangles, Amma wanted me to wear it always saying that it's good for the baby. And I did follow because I really respect Amma's feelings. And she always wanted a baby girl for herself. She did not, but then when I got married, she used to buy me so many stuff, saying that aise dress karo, this will look good. She loves when girls get ready, and she loves making them get, help them in getting ready. So she used to buy me a lot of stuff, and unfortunately, I was opposite to Amma. I am very low key. I don't like to get dressed oftenly, but she used to say, "Nalla palichchane irkunu kanna." She used to always say, "Palichchane irkunu, go to parlor, get this done, eyebrows pannuka, ipdi irukada."
That boy sucks, guys.
When she was pregnant, she wanted a baby girl, but she got a baby boy. And when I was pregnant, even then she wanted baby girl, to say everyone in the family. Ganesh's side, everyone wanted a baby girl, and even I wanted baby girl, and I had decided name as Ira. And I was so sure it's baby girl, but Ganesh, I don't know how he got to know, he was 100% sure it's baby boy, and my dad also. Only these two people were sure that it's baby boy. I wanted baby girl, I had decided the name, and I even added few clothes for the baby girl.
Yeah, all the shoppings were being done in advance, guys.
When I was in 8 months, I was feeling very tired and all. I used to feel very sleepy because Ayan was a night baby. So I used to have a lot of movements during night, so I couldn't sleep during night time. So I used to feel very sleepy during daytime. And my team was really very sweet. When after going to office, if I say that I want to take a power nap, they used to say, please sleep, take rest. And definitely my team members also pampered me a lot. They used to buy me a lot of chocolates and ice cream, whatever I wanted. There are a few friends of mine, Sura, he used to pamper me immensely. And Ramya was very strict to me. Ramya, I think you guys know.
Yeah.
She used to say, "Dekh ke khana." And the most strict friend I ever had was Amar. He used to literally torture me. He never used to let me eat anything. He used to brainwash me, saying that khala ye acha nahi hai, khala ye acha nahi hai, khala aise nahi hona, khala aise nahi karna. So he was very strict regarding my food habits, and he used to make sure that I don't work late. And they're not my teammates, they're actually my very good friend. Friends, they really took care of me so well during my pregnancy. When I was in 8th month, they took my workload as well. And when I got into 9th month, I have to tell this, Amar, he said that I should never have caesarean. By God forbidden, if I had caesarean, he would never ever talk to me, and I should never ever show my face to him. Even Ganesh did not scare me this bad. Neither my parents nor doctor, but he did. Literally, he used to say, every day he used to tell me, "Khala, normal delivery. Khala, normal delivery." Because he had sisters and he know the pain and all. So he was behind my life. So at least for that, every day I used to pray, "Allah, please meko normal delivery kara do."
That was a time in our friend circle, there were a lot of caesareans being happened, and we were very concerned, like if she goes through that pain, I don't want that to happen. And that's why even I forced her, and I might have shouted at her that she is not doing any household work. So eventually she used to do household work, and the best work that one person can do is sweep and wipe the floor. One more thing I want to share is that now she has done the talking part till the 9th month. I would like to say that during the pregnancy time, I learned driving, guys. So
I didn't know car
driving. So I was like, "Yaar, ab to gaadi chalana seekhna hi padega," because like till when, we can like depend upon Uber or Ola or those things. And so I decided to join a driving school, like Maruti driving school, which is in Nanakramguda. So I went there and I learned for like 10 days. It was a 10-day course, and Yeah, they trained me really well. And so during the ninth month, I got her dad's car at my place because he was not using. By the time, I think he was retired also. So that car wasn't in so much of use. So I told her, let me practice in this car, small car. So that was, guys, Hyundai Ion. The size of that car was only this much. And I was like 6 feet. And I was not even able to like fit into that car. So whenever I used to sit in that car, I used to keep that seat to the extreme back. And that is how I started learning. And I used to go alone, driving alone. And somehow I managed to get that confidence. Like that is how I started learning how to drive car.
When I was in my ninth month, Amma was promoted and she had training in Telangana. So Amma Appa, they both came and Amma had training at Yadigiri Gutta. So Appa was staying with us during that time. My due date was Feb 14th. During my 9 month, mom used to come in the morning and used to leave in the evening. One fine day, I think over weekend or Friday, Samira did not have shoot. It was off for Seema as well. So we decided that Samira, Seema, mom would stay with us that night and we would spend some quality time. And then I had severe pains and we thought I got into labor. My mom, she poured hot water on me. I don't know what was the logic. She said, you'll feel much better if hot water is poured on your legs. Samira started car. And then we went, we packed all our bag. I mean, the hospital bag was already packed. Everything was packed. We dumped everything in the car and we went to hospital. And we went for the checkup. And doctor said it was a false alarm and I can eat Dolo whenever I have such severe pain since I was in my last month. And then when we started from hospital back home, the car broke. The car broke down and it did not get started. We tried for very long time. Then since I was pregnant, Ganesh made sure that we go back home and he stayed there with the car. Then after coming back home, Samira told me that Appa have shooting, I have to go to Chennai. So until I come back, you should not deliver the baby. And she told baby also ki I'm going to Chennai. If you're planning to come out, come only on 31st because that's my off and I'll be here in Hyderabad. And she was in Chennai shooting for Pagal Nilav, I believe. One fine day I was repeatedly going to washroom and I felt I'm passing urine unknowingly. Then I called my doctor and I said, this is what is happening. I think I'm passing urine unknowingly and I have changed many a times till now. And she said, you should come and visit us immediately. And then I told Samira also. Samira spoke to her co-artist and she said, I think her water broke. She should go to hospital immediately. But I did not believe anything. Though the hospital bag was packed, I told mommy, it's just a regular checkup. And Appa also said, whenever I used to go to hospital, Appa used to keep Vibhuti on my head so that I go safely and deliver baby and come back. But this time when I was going, Appa wanted to do the same rituals. I said, okay. I mean, I didn't want to hurt him. Then he kept Vibhuti and then we came. I knew, I was telling Appa, kuch nahi hoga, main wapas aa rahi hu. It's just a checkup. But still, Appa wanted to do his routine. And he kept Vibhuti and then we started to hospital. And I was telling mummy on the way. Mummy was like, Bablu ko bol do, Bablu ko bol do.
So, once I came to know about this, I immediately rushed from office and I came home. And Samira had kept her car there. Okay, it was EcoSport and that was the first time I was driving that big car. I was so used to drive that small car. So I took that car I was driving really slowly because I was not used to drive an SUV by then. So I slowly, I reached hospital. Somehow I reached hospital and I parked the vehicle and I immediately rushed up and there I saw she was in the maternity ward. Yeah, she was there and with her mother, and doctor said that
she might deliver
anytime soon.
They were just waiting. My water broke, and they were just waiting for the pains for normal delivery. And that night, it was 30th Jan when I went to hospital. And that night, Sura and Amar, they visited hospital. Yeah. Even then, Amar was saying, "You're not having a C-sec."
Yeah. So during that time, there was no sign of any pain from her, and doctors were waiting for a normal delivery to happen, because we were adamant that it should be a normal delivery only. And she was also ready for normal delivery. And we had to wait for like one entire day, guys. So
next day, mummy Ganesh told that I would stay back, and he asked mummy to go home and get freshen up. Mom went home. That's when my pain started. Luckily, my pain started, and Ganesh called mom, and he called mom, and then I was shifted to the labor room. Ganesh was my side, and the pains were horrible. I had to go, and I was just shouting at Ganesh very badly, saying that it's all because of you. I wasn't ready. I cannot go through this pain and all that stuff. And he was like, I'm sorry, sambhal lo, sab theek ho jayega. He was rubbing my forehead, and he was being very calm and composed. And then my mom arrived. Ganesh haven't eaten anything by then. Though I got food from the hospital because I was a patient there, he did not get anything. So he was waiting for my mom to come. Mom came, and mom told Ganesh ki go and have food. Ganesh, he just went, and then I had very severe pain, and I was crying out of pain. Then I was asking, because I wanted Ganesh beside. Because seeing my pain, my mom was also crying, which was more painful for me. Because when someone is crying in front of you, you feel very weak. So I was feeling that. So I told mummy, where is Bebu? Mummy said, he went down to eat food. Then I got more annoyed because of that pain. I was like, okay, tell him that not to come back. I can deliver by myself. Ask him to go back home. Then my mom called him, and he did not eat anything. He came up running, and he was my side until then. Ganesh was my side after that. He did not go anywhere. He was just on water, guys, until I delivered. And doctor was coming and checking regularly. Around 2 o'clock or 1 o'clock, she came and she checked, and she said there is a lot of time for the delivery. Maybe it would be by night 8 or 9, because baby hasn't come down. So let's wait, she said. And I was very scared, because I was already going through pain, and going through that pain until 8, it would be more painful for me. I was just praying ki the baby comes down. And finally, when doctor came and checked at 3, the doctor said, the baby's come down, so we will have delivery now. And they started getting ready for the delivery. They gave me MMR, and they cleaned everything. I think that was, I was given MMR before I had intense pains.
Pain.
And then they were getting ready for the normal delivery. Everything was set up. Around 4 o'clock, I started pushing the baby. And everyone were telling, push. I was so annoyed with the push. What?
No, she was shouting at me unnecessarily. I was in the theater, guys. So
yeah,
I was there with her. And I experienced that beautiful moment, and yes, there was Ayan.
On 31st Jan, 4:15
p.m. he was delivered. Yeah.
And he listened to Samira. When Samira said that you should come on 31st, he listened to Samira when he was in my womb, and he came on 31st. That's how they have their bond even now.
So, once Ayan was out, and he was being cleaned and by the nurses, that is when I think everybody, all the family members, they came during that time. My dad came, Anwar's mom and her grandmother, she came. And obviously her
sister
came, and dad, everybody was there.
Yeah.
But I insisted the nurse and I told the nurse
that, and even my family members
and the entire family member, that I should be the first person to lift Ayan, lift Ayan in my hand. I should feel him first because I went through that pain.
he literally when Ayan was out, he was like, the doctor said congratulations, it's a boy. Then he said, I knew it. And when Ayan was out, when sisters were taking him out, he literally left me and went behind him. That's how he loves him immensely, yeah, more than me.
So it's not that I did not take care of her. I was just worried how they are going to clean and all those stuff. So I went. And yeah, I took him in my arm. For the first time, it was a beautiful feeling. And after that, everybody came, they left and...
And I was the last person to take him.
Yeah, because she was... she was not...
Exhausted. Yeah, it's not like that. Everyone were enjoying and then I told, mera turn kab aega, meko de do.
You were not conscious only.
I was conscious, but not...
Yeah, she was very tired. She was not in a position to hold any baby.
But I was given Ayan and then I started crying. It was a very special moment.
Yeah.
And I can still feel how special that is. And I'm lucky to be his mom. He's a fighter. We had a few challenges. As I mentioned, I had bleeding and all. I ate a lot of junk. But still he fought and he's a very strong kid, just like his dad. And he has everybody's love. And I was little upset because I wanted baby girl and I decided the name Ayra. Then that's how Samira came up with name Ayra ko Ayan kar denge.
Yeah.
And that's how Ayan came.
Yeah.
And that's really very sweet of Amma Appa that they gave us liberty to decide the name of our baby. They never said that you should keep this, you should keep that. Ye sab nahi chalega. They said it's your baby. You keep whatever you want. You call him whatever you want.
Yeah.
So we are very lucky to be his parents, and he's very lucky to be our kid.
So guys, this was our beautiful pregnancy journey and. Now Ayan is like 4 years old and we decided to share this journey with you guys and hope you guys like it. Please do subscribe to our channel and enjoy more videos like this.